So welcome back, guys. In this class, we'll discuss it's another session of three-phase star connection for three-wire system. So three-phase, three-wire system. So I'm not representing source here now. The source may be a line voltages. We don't need that. Now we need to concentrate on load only. So initially, what we did is we have a supply phase star and load. Okay. So you don't have any neutral connection this for three phase three wire system. So to find the load current, IA, IB, IC, we relied on potential across this tree, okay, V and naught. So we find with the formula of V and naught equal to VA, VAN, YN, all these things, we found N naught, and after getting N naught, we find voltage across this, and after getting voltage across this potential, and we find IA equal to V naught by Z. Okay, that's the other part. Now, in spite of doing all these things, we simply what we'll do is we transfer this star to delta. Okay, we transfer this star to delta. So I'm naming this value as, since it is in between the ZA and ZC, I name this as ZAC. And I name it this as ZAB, and I name it this as ZBC. Okay, so we are transferring this star to delta without disturbing these terminals. Okay, so whatever the values you transfer, the line currents will not change. Okay, the line currents is same for this star connection and this for delta connection. Okay. We removing this star and we are converting this whole terminal to a delta without having any effect on load currents. Okay, so whatever the source, whatever the supply from the water supply, the load current is traveling to the load, it is same if at all if we connect this load in the star or load in delta. Okay, so now our thing is to find ZAB. So how we'll find the ZAB equal to, you have simply, so what do you do for ZAB means ZA into ZB. So from looking here, we have ZA, ZB. So what we do is we find ZA, ZB plus ZB, ZC plus ZA, ZC divided by opposite point. So what is having ZC? So this is the simple formula to remember to ZAB. So multiplication of all individual AB, BC, CA by opposite of this. If you look like this, if you see opposite is ZC. Or similarly, what we again this can be reduced to ZA, ZP plus ZC, ZC get cancelled. ZC plus ZA. So this is one form. So ZA plus ZEB plus ZA, ZB by AC. And again, ZB is equal to what? ZB plus ZC plus ZB, ZC by ZA. And what about ZAC equal to what? ZA plus ZC plus ZA, ZC by opposite of that ZC is equal to what? So ZAB, ZAB means ZAC, opposite of ZA is ZB. Okay, this is the formula to find the transfer star to delta connection. After finding the star to delta connection, you know carefully what you know the thing. If you convert this star to delta, the things get very easy. So from beginning, from before, we know that the line voltages is exactly equal to the phase voltage of each delta winding. Is that clear? A, B, C. You know that. What are the line voltage? It is voltage across this is VAC, and across this is VBC, and across this is VCA. You know that. Okay. So you convert this star to delta, and you will find the value, you know the value of VAC from the supply mains, and we will find current IA. Okay. The real current phase currents. Let us say this is the current flowing here is I. AB. Okay, I'll draw in big form. this is we obtained ZAC, this we obtained ZAB, and this we obtained ZBC. Okay, so after finding ZA, ZB, ZP, we can find directly current, that is I, this is A, and this is B, and this is C. So we find current flowing through this is, I'm naming as IAB, and current flowing from in this branch is, let us say in this form, that is IBC. So this is current flowing from this, current is flowing like this, therefore this is naming as ICA. Okay, so we will find IAB, ICA, IA. So how we will find IAB means, so voltage across this is what? So VA equal to VAB by ZAB. So we will find IBC equal to what? VBC by ZBC. And ICA equal to what? VCA by ZAC. Okay, so we will find the currents IA. After finding currents, phase currents IA, IB, this is so IAB, IBC, ICA. Okay, after finding the currents IAB, IBC, ICA, we can find line currents. So that is the load currents, line currents, that is IA equal to what? So at this point we apply KCL. So IA equal to IAB minus ICA, you know that. And current IB equal to what? So at this point, what are the current entering is IB and IAB is entering. Okay, so IB equal to what? IB plus IAB equal to IBC. Therefore, IB equal to IBC minus IAB. Okay, so here IA is entering and ICA is entering. Okay, now again, what about IC equal to? So what are the current entering here? IA is entering and IBC is entering. Therefore, IC equal to ICA minus IBC. So we will find this line currents finally after finding the phase currents. So first step is convert star to delta. After that, second step is find phase currents that are IAB, IBC and ICA, and third is find line currents. Simple. Line currents are IA, IB and IC. And if you find the line currents, so that same line current will flow through this star. We have observed that. So the line current IA is flowing through IA, and IB will flow to IC, and IB is flowing like this. So if you know the line currents, then you can find the voltage across this. This is 0 and A. So VA naught equal to what? ZA into IA. Agree with me? And VB naught equal to what? ZB into IB. And VC naught equal to what? ZC into IC. Okay, this is the flow to find the whatever basic upon the question they may ask you to find. They may ask you to find line currents, or they may ask you to find phase voltages, or they may ask you to find ZAB, ZBC, ZC, and they may ask you to find whatever the phasor diagrams and all. So this is about star to delta conversion of star three phase three wire system. Okay, you have another method. So we have another third method to find line currents, load currents. Okay, in that which is naming as Maxwell's loop current method. Okay, so in this method what we do is, so we already know that the load is star connected. Okay. So this is a letter. Now I am taking R Y. So R Y B. Okay. So you have given the supply line voltage. Okay. So my thing is not depending upon what of the source, what of the load source you connect, what is it, maybe star connected or delta connected, but we rely on line voltages that is giving to the load. Okay, this is ZR. Now it will be terminated as, so Z is ZB and this is ZY, let us say. Now our thing is to find load currents, that is IR, let us say IY, and let us say IB. But what are the things we have? Only ZA, ZR, ZY, ZB. Okay, this is ZR, R, Y, B. Now we apply a loop here. That is, let us say this current I1 is flowing, and we'll face a current I2 is flowing. The voltage, let us, this between these two lines, we'll, line voltages, we'll name it like this. So if you find voltage across this loop, means we'll find like this. Okay, VYB, we name it as, and it is VRY. So apply loop here. What happens is, so minus, so from in this loop, what do we get? Minus VRY plus I1 into ZR plus IY, ZY into I1 minus I2 equal to 0. Agree with me? You know the RY value, you know ZR value, you know ZY value. So unknown values is ZI1, I2. This is one loop equation. Another loop equation is minus VYB plus I2 minus I1 into ZY plus ZB into I2. Okay, this is second loop equation. You know IY value. So for example, I'm giving as 440 volts line voltage. Okay, you'll apply 440 volts RYB and 440 volts YYB. And you know the values of ZR, ZY, ZB, all the values, but unknown values is I1. You'll find I1 and I2. Okay, after finding I1, I2, so you can know that from this, IR value equal to what? So IR value means I1. Okay, IY value is what? So IY value is what? IY is I2 minus I1. And IB, so this is IB value. So IB equal to what? Minus of I2. Okay, so you are obtaining the line currents. Okay, the line currents by loop analysis, that is called Maxwell's loop current method. After finding this line currents, you know that you can find voltage across these branches. Okay, so voltage across this, let us say it is VR0, and this is VB0, and this is VZ0, G, VY0. Okay, so again VR0 equal to what? VR0 equal to IR into ZR, and VV0 equal to IB into ZB. So this is RYB phase. Okay, so this capital I should keep, sorry. So before I, that is different, then this is different. So VY0 equal to IC, IY into ZY. Okay, so this is another method. So we have three methods. We have first method is we find VN0. Okay, that is VAN YA plus VBN YB plus VCN YC. YA plus YB plus YC method. After finding this, we find phase voltages and all. And the second method, we find star to delta. And the third method is we found Maxwell's. Okay. So these are the difficulties we have seen in star load, but in delta load we have not seen all these things. We simply gave the phase voltage across this line voltage. Okay. Thank you guys for your patience listening. In the next few classes, we'll discuss the problems on this star connected loan. I'll give two examples. Thank you.